So I didn't really plan any of that out. But yeah, I mean, if you could say that there was something which was pushing me in that direction, that perhaps I could attribute it to my exile consciousness. In the fact that I was, you know, just about 9 or 10 years old when we were kicked out of Kashmir, and that stayed with me. I suppose that stayed with a lot of people, but somehow I think I got more, you know, in connect with it. That may have influenced some of the decisions that I took. And finally, idea of doing something for the civilization in whatever small way possible, I think perhaps it could come from that consciousness. But once I jumped into this field, what really kept me engaged was the fact that a lot of people felt that resonance with whatever I spoke and whatever I wrote. And that, I thought, was an indication of shared consciousness, right? So I had a consciousness of exile, and I assumed that, you know, I had assumed that it was just me. But when I interacted with a lot of people, I found that even without being kicked out of their places of stay or their native indigenous, you know, homelands, they still managed to have that feeling of exile. And that gave me an idea that, you know, it's not necessary that you need to be kicked out or you need to physically be in exile. You could also mentally be exiled. So that's been something that has really kind of helped me to frame my thoughts and to work more towards, in whatever ways we can, towards building or the civilizational resurgence that we are all in.